Thank you for watching a Budapest Beacon interview. My name is Ben Novak. Today I'm speaking to Kim Lane Shepley. She is a professor of sociology and international affairs here at Princeton University. Your title goes on and on and on, but for the sake of simplicity, we'll keep it there.
Yeah.
Kim, we're stepping into election season now. Well, we're already in election season in Hungary. There is going to be a lot of foreign coverage of what's happening in Hungary. A lot of journalists are going to go there, and they're going to have to get their feet wet very quickly to kind of understand the complexities of the election system. Can you summarize for me three important points that anybody, journalists included, should know about the Hungarian election system?
So first of all, the rules for the election system were written for this particular political space to ensure that only one party could possibly win, and that's the current governing party, Fidesz. So in lots of ways, the election's over already. So the idea that there's any kind of suspense in the result is actually something that we really, well, whoever thinks there's suspense doesn't know what the rules are.
So wishful rules, thinking.
Wishful thinking on the part of those who want Orbán out. Mm-hmm. So the rules are designed to ensure his victory again. That's the first thing. The second thing is that the election campaign is happening in a space that is not a free and fair space. So the governing party controls the media that most people see. They have backup from their own sort of NGO sector. They're trying to put all the opposition groups, and I might say not just the democratic opposition groups of the left, but also Jobbik's from the right, under all kinds of pressure. So the state audit office is just trying to take all the money away from these groups that they have to run campaigns under the guise of finally enforcing election laws that have never been enforced before. So the opposition parties are going in impoverished to this campaign. And then finally, you know, it's not all a Fidesz conspiracy. Part of it is that the political spectrum can't get its act together to figure out what it wants. So, you know, when journalists come in, this is not a normal election in which you have a government and an organized opposition. This is an election in which you have a governing party that's fixed the entire rules of the game and the entire surroundings, you know, sort of within which this game is being played. And one of the things that they've succeeded in doing also is demobilizing the opposition. Mm-hmm. So, you know, this is not really an election where the results are in doubt. And the thing that I think foreign journalists need to understand is how much has been done before they ever set foot in the country to ensure this result. So this is not going to be an election where, you know, ballot boxes are stuffed. So the kind of thing election observers look for is not going to be where the action is. The action is in the rules that set up the system.
If election laws aren't written as part of a normal democratic process, are the elections themselves democratic? Is the government that comes to power after that democratic?
Right. The election laws that were written were voted on only by the current governing party. This was in place for the 2014 election, and most of that framework has stayed in place. And what's actually interesting about the way these election rules rig the result is that if you just read them in the abstract, it doesn't look like there's anything wrong. So, for example, most of the districts in the parliament, a little over half, I guess, of the districts in the parliament are single-member districts that use the exact same rules as American congressional elections. It's called a first-past-the-post system, so you have multiple candidates running, and whoever gets the most votes wins, even if they don't get a majority. Mm-hmm. Right? Under the old rules in Hungary, you'd have a bunch of parties, you'd get the top two candidates, and you'd keep having, well, you'd have a second runoff result if the first time the candidate didn't get 50%. So under the old rules in Hungary, every member of parliament from a district had to have a majority in their district. Mm-hmm. Now it's just, you know, you could get 30% and still win. And given the way the spectrum is working, Fidesz is the big party in the middle, but there's a big party on their right, and there's a fragmentation of parties on their left. And if you get six or seven candidates running, then all Fidesz has to get is more votes than anybody else in that district. So Fidesz could theoretically win a seat with 20% of the vote.
Sure. You know?
So anyway, so that's the kind of thing that was happening. There's nothing wrong with the rule in the abstract. What's wrong with the rule is the rule in that context pretty much guarantees that Fidesz, which will have plurality support across a wide array of districts, will always win against a fragmented opposition.
And especially if there's many parties running.
Exactly. And actually, you know, last time in 2014, the left made some semblance of, you know, a coalition, tried to get most of the parties together. And this time, they haven't been able to manage it. So the left can't win because it's not unified. and the right can't win because the left is there, and vice versa. So, you know, all the opposition to Fidesz cancels each other out. Now, you know, the opinion polls show that overwhelming majorities would rather have a different government. But then that's question one. Question two is a government of the left or a government of the right, and there the population splits in half. And in that system, Fidesz can win with this rule.
If you could direct the OSCE election monitors to look at particular elements of this electoral process in Hungary, what would you tell them to look at?
Well, so first these rules, and I've laid them out actually in 2014. I published a set of explanations of how these rules work. But the second is that the election machinery itself, like if they're going there on election day, the election machinery itself is in the hands of Fidesz appointees. And so opposition parties don't really have a say in adjudicating disputes under the rules and everything else. But the other thing I really think they need to look at is what's happening behind the scenes to tally the votes. Now, I say behind the scenes because Hungary has a very complex election system, and it requires not just counting the votes, but doing the math. And by doing the math, just to give you one sense, every Hungarian casts two votes, one for their personal representative.
And another for the party.
Another for the party. Okay, so if you just counted them up, it would be easy. But all the lost votes, all the votes that don't produce a candidate on the individual constituency side, get transferred over and added to the parties on the other side. Mm-hmm. So if, you know, Fidesz wins a seat, but Jobbik got 200 votes in that seat, 200 Jobbik votes would get moved over and added to the Jobbik party votes. And Fidesz last time added something which is called winner compensation. So if Fidesz got 300 votes in that district and Jobbik got 200 votes in that district, then 99 votes for Fidesz move over and get counted for Fidesz because Fidesz could have won that seat with 201 votes, so 99 of the votes they got weren't necessary.
Now, I'm not a mathematician. Now, I'm not a mathematician, and this is all too complicated for me, but that certainly seems to me like one vote for the winner gets amplified.
Right. There are almost no systems in the world that have that. Now,
we call it a Hungaricum.
Hungaricum. Well, actually, you know, it was invented by Silvio Berlusconi in Italy. And, you know,
Italiano Hungaricum.
Exactly. So, you know, and that was exactly, shall we say, not a fully free and fair election system when Berlusconi kept winning and winning. And he invented this rule, and then it got borrowed by the Hungarians. So the problem is, but here's the dilemma. When you see that votes counted in one, you know, on one side of the line, get, you know, added up, and then there's leftover votes, and then they get transferred over to this other ballot, and then they get recounted over there. Anyway, there's some math involved. It's actually pretty complicated math.
Sounds like it.
And nobody's seen the algorithm. There used to be a company, it was a private company that ran the software that did this calculation. And then Fidesz nationalized that company. And they have refused to show or have anyone test that algorithm ever since they've been running these elections. So one of the questions, maybe the, you know, oh dear monitors can go in there and say, can we see a test of how this works? Because, you know, it's not just that you have to have the votes counted accurately, sort of literally at the polls, but there's all this math that has to happen afterwards before you get the full results. All the votes have to be transferred, they have to be recalculated, and all this kind of stuff. And that is all done by a computer that where no one's checked the program.
No one?
No one that I know of. I mean, I'm sure Fidesz has checked the program, but they haven't let anyone in to see it. So that was something ODIHR is the Office of Democratic Institutions and Human Rights. They're the election monitors. Mm-hmm. And I don't think they got in to see it last time. So, you know, they need to get their computer people there to look at exactly how these votes are tallied.